So let's figure out whether Lake Sarez can destroy Central Asia. Lake Sarez is considered the most beautiful and at the same time the most dangerous body of water in Tajikistan. It was formed over 100 years ago as a result of an earthquake. In November, the British publication Daily Mail described the lake as a time bomb. According to the UN and many leading experts, the natural dam blockage can break through at any moment. In the event of a catastrophic breakthrough, the wave height could reach 150 meters, affecting residents of four countries. Official Dushanbe claims that there is no reason to worry since the state of the environment is carefully monitored by specialists. Izvestia newspaper examined the situation in more detail. In the heart of the mountains of Central Asia, there is a lake that can spill out its power at any moment. Its waters breaking down will carry a destructive mud flow that will reach the Aral Sea itself and affect four countries at once. Just 113 years ago, amidst landslides, destruction, and chaos, Lake Sarez appeared. It was born in the depths of the mountains of Tajikistan and, ironically, will probably end its existence as dramatically as it began. This natural reservoir, locked in a narrow river valley, contains a whopping 17 cubic kilometers of water. It is guarded by a natural dam 567 meters high, consisting of soil and rock fragments. In the event of a breakthrough, all this water would burst out at once at great speed, causing destruction. The potential of Lake Sarez was known in Tsarist Russia and then carefully studied in the USSR. Today, the few residents of mountain villages know what to do in the event of a breakthrough because the danger of this lake remains significant. The mountain river Bartang, born of melting snow and glaciers of the Pamirs, meandered through a narrow gorge like a silver stream. Under the overhanging mountains were two villages, Sarez and Usoy, separated by 20 kilometers. The lake swallowed them. The upper reaches of Bartang are called Aksu by locals, and the middle, Murgab, which sometimes leads to confusion in various sources. Late in the evening of February 18, 1911, at 22:30 a.m., people woke up from strong tremors and a deafening roar. The plates under the Pamirs began to move again. Even seismographs in St. Petersburg at the Pulkovo Observatory, 3,800 kilometers away, recorded these vibrations. On the earthquake intensity scale, this event was rated at 9 points out of a possible 12, which means destructive. The magnitude was 7.4 on the Richter scale. A cold winter morning arrived. The residents of Sarez, who had spent the night in fear and anxiety, woke up to find that the usual crystal clear highland air had been replaced by a thick and suffocating dust curtain. We will never know what the residents of Usoy, a village located 20 kilometers downstream from Sarez, experienced. Of all its inhabitants, only three survived, who had come to visit relatives in Sarez the day before and stayed overnight. People rushed to help their neighbors. After passing another sharp turn in the valley, they saw a dark mass in the distance. The closer they got, the clearer it became. The village of Usoy was completely buried under a giant landslide. Later, scientists would find out that a mountain massif with a volume of 2 cubic kilometers and a mass of 6 billion tons had collapsed. This was enough to completely block a valley 5 kilometers wide, along which the Bartang River flowed. This is how the highest dam in the world was formed, 567 meters high, called the Usoy Dam in memory of the village. Staff Captain Zymkin, responsible for this Pamir corner of the Russian Empire, quickly got to the scene 2 months later, in April, to assess the consequences of the devastating earthquake. 14. He will be unpleasantly surprised. In his report to his superiors, Staff Captain Zymkin will write about the village of Usoy, which no longer exists, and about a giant blockage of mud and rocks, the height of which he estimated at 650 meters. He will also mention a small lake that began to form due to the fact that the river, having encountered an insurmountable obstacle, began to accumulate water in front of the blockage. But Zymkin will be even more surprised in September when he returns to the territory entrusted to him. He will discover that the small lake has turned into a large, full-flowing lake. The residents of Sarez, located 20 kilometers above the blockage, were already actively preparing to move. The water was inexorably approaching their village. Their foresight was justified. Already in October, the roofs of the last houses in Sarez were hidden underwater. Thus, at an altitude of 3,255 meters above sea level, Lake Sarez of the dam type appeared. Today it contains a huge volume of water, 17 cubic kilometers. The water filled the river valley in front of the Usoy Dam, spreading 70 kilometers upstream and rising to a height of 185 to 505 meters. Sarez, after which the lake is named, now rests at a depth of 240 meters. The rapid filling of Lake Sarez ended 15 years after the earthquake in 1926. Until that time, the depth increased by 9 meters per year. It seemed that at this rate, the water would sooner or later gush over the dam, but nature knows how to balance itself. Since 1942, the water level began to fluctuate, but overall remained stable. The water found a way out. It began to seep through the dam in small springs. Today, there are 57 of them. The news of the appearance of Lake Sarez, a size unprecedented for a landslide lake, caused a real sensation in the scientific community. Scientists immediately began to vigorously discuss two important topics. Did the earthquake cause the landslide or vice versa? And what will happen if the landslide breaks? The threat of a natural dam breaking is real and frightening in its unpredictability, because it can happen at any moment. Three possible scenarios are being considered. Lake Sarez is located in a zone of high seismic activity. On average, an earthquake of magnitude 7 occurs here once every 100 years, and earthquakes of magnitude 8 to 9 occur once every 250 to 2,000 years. The energy of these tremors is enough to destroy the landslide created by the earthquake of 1911. A natural dam made of soil and rocks is also subject to erosion due to water filtration. Any thin stream breaking through the blockage can become a fatal illustration of the saying, "Where it's thinnest, there it breaks." Complex processes occur here. In one place, the water crushes the blockage from the inside. In another, the leaks are clogged. This is almost a living organism, the behavior of which cannot be predicted, even with the most advanced artificial intelligence. In 1967, another potential threat was discovered. An area on the right bank of the lake was identified from which a landslide could occur. The likelihood of this event is especially high, given the earthquakes discussed earlier. Geologists estimate the volume of loose material in this area at 0.5 to 2 cubic kilometers, and if it collapses into the lake, it will cause a wave that will spill over the blockage, destroying it. All three scenarios lead to catastrophic consequences. In an attempt at a sad joke, we can say that this is the most original way to refill the Aral Sea. If Lake Sarez breaks through, the water flows, carrying soil and rocks with them, will quickly reach the lower reaches of the Amu Darya, causing destructive mud flows. The access zone of Lake Sarez includes areas along the Bartangpanj Amu Darya river chain, where 6 million people live in Afghanistan, Tajikistan, Turkmenistan, and Uzbekistan. The Bartang does not break off in Lake Sarez. The water that breaks through the blockage continues on its way, creating a potential threat to everyone who lives along its shores. On the one hand, there are many blockage lakes in the world that remain stable, but Lake Sarez is exceptional in its scale. Moreover, studies have shown that at least 9 blockage lakes previously existed in this area. Where are they now? They are no longer there. Their blockages have been washed away or destroyed. The last of them, Prasaraz Lake, is known to us for its relative freshness. Its 4-kilometer dam was partially destroyed by water. Sarez Lake contains a colossal volume of water, locked behind a dam 567 meters high, situated at an altitude of 3,255 meters, if it breaks, its streams will fall down the narrow river valleys at an enormous speed. The most dire forecasts speak of a wave up to 120 meters high. All this makes us think about how to protect the 6 million people living downstream. Is it possible to stop Sarez? They started with a tunnel, ended with an observation booth. The enormity of the Usoy phenomenon makes us think about the weakness of human forces. In 2000, Tajikistan, Uzbekistan, Kyrgyzstan, and Kazakhstan appealed to the international community with a request to attract the best minds to solve the problem of a potential breakthrough. Lake Sarez and provide funding. Unfortunately, their efforts did not produce the expected results. The funding provided was as limited as the proposed solution. An observation booth was installed on Lake Sarez to transmit a signal that would activate a warning system in settlements downstream. Skeptics pointed to the insufficient assessment of the scale of the threat. If the breach were catastrophic, the booth might be washed away first before it could transmit a signal. The funding also allowed for the creation of several primitive safety islands on the surrounding slopes for residents living below Sarez. These islands were equipped with supplies of water, food, and essential items. But that was where the solution to the problem ended. In the event of a strong earthquake, none of the proposed options would be able to prevent a catastrophe. Therefore, Lake Sarez continues to be not only a source of the purest mountain water, but also a symbol of the destructive force hidden in the depths of our planet. Stay with us and you will learn a lot of interesting things.